guys. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. Information that I have for you today, I think, is very important. It's been a week since we had the magnitude 6.2 earthquake there off the coast of Petrolia, California. And I want to show you the Blanco zone. Altogether, there's been 245 earthquakes within the last month in this location. The news is not covering anything that's going on of late, even though these earthquakes are continuing. The most recent was a magnitude 3.2. There was also a 4.7. This was today. Petrolia had a 3.3. That was yesterday. That was right down there. Many scientists believe that the next large earthquake, a magnitude 8 or greater, is going to be caused by the stress that has built up in the Gorda plate. And we'll have a partial failure of the Cascadia subduction zone when that happens. Yep, this is the area for the next large earthquake, a magnitude 8 or greater. And when that happens, it's going to trigger adjoining faults. They know that the Little Salmon Fault, which goes up by the city of Fortuna, is probably going to rupture along with that failure. There was other damage from that 6.2 earthquake that occurred on December 20th. Here we have an image of damage that was done on the interchange between Highway 1 and 36. They say it was cosmetic damage, and weather permitting, they'll get out and do some repairs. A abandoned cheese factory, a creamery there in Humboldt County. The Louetta Cheese Factory, the roof and part of the wall collapsed, and now they got signs up warning people to stay away. For each magnitude higher earthquake, that means the energy produced release is 100 times stronger. In Ferndale, they had between 15 to 20 windows that broke from the magnitude 6.2. In this paper here, it talks about past earthquakes. 2010, 6.5 intraplace earthquake within the subduction Gorda plate. And how the locking depth on this slab is at least 14 kilometers, which suggests the next magnitude earthquake rupture will likely reach the coastline and strong shaking should be expected there. In past videos, I talked about these locked zones. Right here, we got one where stress has built up for a magnitude 8.0 earthquake or greater. And I believe that was this earthquake right here, a magnitude 5.7, that over 1,007 people reported to USGS that they felt it. It had an intensity level of 5, almost 17 kilometers in depth, which is about 10 miles in depth, and all earthquakes are measured from sea level. And this paper states that although the 2015 earthquake did not induce strong transient deformation on the subducted Gorda plate that were detected onshore at GPS stations. And here's the location of the 2010 6.5 earthquake. It was compressional and extensional, and that was also within the Gorda plate. 9,027 people reportedly felt that earthquake back then. The 2010 earthquake imposed a strong stress perturbation on the Gorda plate interface, with which we can rule out a very shallow down dip limit on the locking patch on the slab, owing to the lack of detectable signal onshore GPS. The locking depth on the slab, once again, is at least 14 kilometers, which suggests that the next magnitude 8 earthquake rupture will likely reach the coastline and strong shaking should be expected there once again. And we'll go back to where that earthquake occurred, right there. More likely, there is a junction here for the Little Salmon Fault Zone, which goes up to the Eel River. Yeah, you can see it, the channel here and the other channel up over here. This monitor here at the top is for the Petrolia monitor. Let me show you it on Google Earth. Right there, it's a borehole. It's a very deep well under the ground, so it does not pick up any outside noise that someone could mistake for an earthquake. And we got two recent earthquakes right there. We got a small one right there. There's the there's the name of the monitor. PB borehole 046. The last earthquake for today of all earthquakes in this location that USGS is reporting is a 2.3 at 8:18, and the before that was 4:53. So none of these right here are being reported. This one here is at maybe 16:58, just after 17:45. I went back another 4 hours. We got a small one here at maybe 14:48. Let's see, we got 13:55 not being reported. Let me pull it over more for you. Okay. 12:07, 12:08. We got a couple more here. This one at 11:25. I don't know. They got one reported, a 3.2 at 11 o'clock Universal, which doesn't show up here for the monitor for Petrolia. So none of these, they're not reporting. Nothing to see. Please move along. They know that this area is going to be the next area for the magnitude 8 or greater earthquake, and they don't want you to get prepared. Those of you that lived there during the 6.2, can you imagine the damage you will have from an 8-point magnitude earthquake? According to USA Today, there was 1,000 people living within Petrolia area. And then about 25,000 within the area that reported strong shaking from that 6.2. We got what? One cheese factory where the walls and roof collapsed. Cosmetic damage to interstates. A few roads that were closed because of rock slides. And they said they saw varying damage, most occurring in the Eel River Valley and South County areas, which is a fault zone which will rupture at the same time as that magnitude 8 earthquake, right there, Fortuna, Eel River, the Little Salmon Fault. You will have shaking for about a minute. And this is the intensity level that you could have, maybe intensity level 12 or 11 or 10, maybe a 9, partial building collapses. Oh, and I didn't mention the tsunami that you might have. More likely that would happen too. I found a seismic hazard paper for the city of Fortuna and about the deformation that has built up, the stress that has built up from the Gorda plate underneath the North American plate, forming what is commonly referred to as the Cascadia subduction zone. And they got a map here showing the Little Salmon Fault and then the offshore chute. There's the Gorda plate. Fortuna is located in a region of high seismicity. More than 60 earthquakes have produced discernible damage in the region since the mid-1800s. Historically, the area suggests there are 6 distinct sources of damaging earthquakes in the region. Number 1, the Gorda plate. Number 2, the Mendocino fault. Number 3, the Mendocino triple junction. Number 4, the northern end of the San Andreas Fault. So that's all I have for you right now. If you have any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for subscribing. And as always, be prepared. I find great strength, calmness. I'm not afraid if I'm prepared. Thank you again very much for watching. Thank you very much for your support. Please stay safe. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you.